next we have Fiona.
Yes.
Fiona Huang, who will be playing the Schumann Adagio and Allegro. Is that right?
Thank you.
you something funny. Before we started, I heard you practicing the and when I heard you practicing that, I was like, oh yeah, that passage, because that's really hard. But I'll tell you something funny about that, which is that how old are you?
14.
Okay, yeah. So when I was 14, when I was your age, I really struggled with that passage. It was like, I still struggle with it, but I struggled with it both in the playing sense and in the mental sense, because I was convinced that whenever I played the piece, like when I got there, I would screw it up, or like, you know, because a few times, you know, I went like, you know, the finger just like goes off the string, right, because it's a tricky shift, and it was just really unfortunate, you know, because every time I played, I just lived with constant fear of missing that shift. And then I didn't play the piece for like, I don't know, 5-6 years. And then when I came back to it, I didn't fear it anymore. I still missed it, but I didn't fear it. I ended up fearing something else, which is the... So anyway, just to give you some motivation, one day, you know, your anxiety about that passage will pass, but anxiety about a different passage will creep up. So, such is the cycle, yeah? Anyway, so yeah, great. So just a couple general things. One is that I wanted to talk for a second about legato, because it's something that I'm very, very interested in. So, you know, it occurred to me that, you know, it's often the case. I remember when I was, your age, I was playing a D major scale for my teacher, Richard Aaron. And I started playing the D major scale, and you know, I went there. And he stopped me after a second. He was like, you know, you're doing portato on every single note. Like, you know. I was like, oh my gosh, I am. You know, and the way you can tell is the stick moves, right? And what's interesting is that doing portato is actually a much harder stroke than not doing it. Because think about it, the first thing you learn how to do on the cello is just play an open string. You know, play twinkle, twinkle. We're not playing. Right, controlling all the, you know, it actually requires a lot of technique to like control the stick in that way. So when I work on legato personally, I like to think of it as just making it easier. You know, of course, it has other difficulties in terms of phrasing. But when you're just playing a simple scale like that, as if you were just playing. So, therefore, one of my favorite ways to practice a lyrical thing like the adagio would be just actually practice on the open string. So, like, let's say you start on an up, right? So, the phrasing you want, I mean, it depends on the bowing, but you're probably going to lead to the down bow, right? And then, so you can really practice. All you need to do with the bow. And then all the rest of the detail comes in the left hand. Right, so yeah. In general, I noticed that your sostenuto was better on your down bows, and it was less good on your up bows. So I'll give you like a good example. In the middle section, the etwas ruhiger, when you have here. It was very good here, but then those three notes, it's very easy. It feels easier, right? But it's really. It also requires more specificity in the left hand, because the shifts need to be managed in a way that doesn't create too much messiness, right? So anyway, that was just a general thing. So you want to try the beginning and think about that. The very good, very beginning of the adagio.
Oh.
Good. Try one more time. Yeah, sorry, because it felt the tempo was a little... Very good.
consistently singing because it sounds a little like there's a change in color on the F, but the change actually should come in the middle of the F, right? It's often a very big habit for a lot of string players, not only cellos, also violinists. When they change the tip, I'll just give this as an example, but it speeds up a little bit. They feel compelled to use all the bow. But actually, I think that the way to have really legato string changes at the tip is to think about playing slower right before the change. So slow down so you can keep it singing all the way through the change. Yeah. And then lastly, here, the speed of the shift, because you can either shift at a fast beat or shift more, or again, capture a little bit at the top, all sorts of things. It's a very lyrical, lyrical moment. It's the first big shift. Anyway, okay, last time for the first two bars. Surprised how many people just kind of play that normally. I really felt that you were, playing chain music with the piano. That was wonderful. The only thing is that at the very end, this downbeat, I think it's very important that you, because it's easy to kind of da da ya da da. But you really want to hear the da da ya da di. How you have the polyphony between your note and the resolution. And then, of course, it makes the transition harder, but that's what the music needs. So yeah, really try to feel again the legato, and then all throughout this passage, you might want to consider changing the bowing because all this it can be very claustrophobic suddenly, suddenly. It's very tricky, but a few options. Yeah, you want to go from the E flat?
Still there.
the very end. Da, da, feel it at the very end. You play, basically play chamber music with the rest. Right. Right? The rest is coming in, you're leaving it, but you have to pass it off to the rest. Yeah. And then, that was beautiful the way you did that second. Yeah, just right from that bar.
So
Yeah, just work on that. And great, actually, I love the way that you interpret this, where that is kind of, I know it's a really, really hard passage, especially with the thumb fingering. Keep it flowing though, because if you kind of feel the technicality, then you're gonna get stuck. So you're gonna just a couple things to discuss. So in the Allegro, the big thing is that the articulation all on the I would have a little more similar to what we were talking about in Prokofiev, just it's kind of, again, you're imitating the horn sound, right? So yeah, just try that. Sorry to cut off the Adagio. Yeah, or it could be a little more off the string. It could be, or try it in context. Yeah.
Sorry.
Try it in context. Yeah, good. I think it's a little too close to the fingerboard. I would.
Thank you.
fortissimo, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's fortissimo with a crescendo.
And by the way, that also gets frettando.
I think that really means that you should need to follow through on the slow instead of just
really
and lead off to the piano. And
so let's go on past the double bar just for a second.
If you're two together, then you fail.
Yeah.
So. Let's see how anarchic you can be.
Great, great playing, fantastic, a lot of fun.
Yeah, great.